Thank you. changed.
Great. So yeah, the OS 7 is out. So I'm like crazy. I'm like really. Hi. So that was the action part of the play. Now we're gonna do the dialogue. If I can get my cover back on my iPad. Okay. We're gonna do the dialogue part of the play, which is you asking questions about your creative process and your work. So what you basically need to do. Say your question and I'll repeat your question into the fabulous microphone.
Fabulous microphone. Which is kind of like this, so we don't have to yell. So your questions about your work, process, and I'll repeat. BYU back in the house. So does anybody have any questions or? Yes. Synopsis. Any tips on writing a synopsis? And what's your name again?
Mike.
So Mike is writing a synopsis. How long do you want it to be? Yeah, fairly short. Yeah, it depends. Yeah, sometimes people say write 2 pages or you want to write, but like this so that people will read it, right? Like that. That's the first thing that came to mind. You know what I mean? You want it to really capture the essence. You're not going to get everything. You know, you might want to go to drama books. You know what drama books are? It's for a play. Yes, you might want to go to, or even if it's a screenplay or a novel, it'll all work. We'll go to drama books and check out the Dramatist Play Service or the Samuel French bits, or you can go online and read them. And read especially the ones of the plays that you know. You know, Mike is an 85-year-old man who has a bunch of money under his mattress, you know. Sylvia, an 89-year-old woman, wants to marry him. Oh, well, whatever. You know, it's like that. It's always something like that, you know. So you can read them and sort of get a feel for, you can even read like synopses of Hamlet, King Lear, those like enormous plays with lots of complicated story and beautiful language, and see how someone might boil it down effectively. So that's kind of it, and sort of take your cues from that, but it should be, you know, it should grab, and it should be relatively short, not so short, but not too long, so that we're like giving every little detail. So DPS or Samuel French online, I'm sure they have them online. Okay, so not like Spark Notes or Cliff Notes, which are whole pages. Okay. Yes, sir. So Brandon wants to know how we develop, you said verbiage, language, dialogue, what they say, right? There are lots of ways to go about it. The easiest way maybe, or I've said this many times before, and those of you who have heard it will go like, oh my God, I'm gonna fall asleep now. But it's relatively quick. Have you ever studied geometry? Yes! Oh, good! Wow, piece of cake. Okay, so in geometry there are, you do those proofs, right? This I'm grasping because I always forget how it goes. You do those proofs, and you have givens, right? Am I right so far? Okay, so one of the givens or the truths, or the things you can take for granted, 2 points make a line. Is that like a truth or a given? 2 points make a line, right? So in playwriting or in writing, we can use that. to write dialogue. Where your character is and where she wants to go. The line of dialogue. Okay? So, for example, if you have a character named Sally, and she dreams of going to Greenland one day, and that's so she and she lives in Texas, West Texas, right, where nothing is green. Okay? Not really, but let's pretend. And she dreams of going to Greenland. She is in West Texas. She dreams of going to Greenland. 2 points make a line. So that will inform what she's talking about, right? The rhythm and all that flavor will develop, but that's the basic thing, right? That's what she's hoping for, okay? That's sort of the core of her desire. 2 points make a line of dialogue. Okay, so if you know where your character is at, and you know where he or she wants to go, then that can give you a lot of information about what they're saying. Okay, that's a way to start. And then sort of, you know, how you shape it, maybe how old they are, what they've been through, you know, their baggage might flavor and color what they say. But that's basically how you find out what they're talking about, what they're obsessing about, right? Okay. Are you gonna come back? Okay, so keep coming back and we'll keep talking about it and see how you're doing. Okay? Yeah.
How green?
Okay. He's done some writing, and you're very inspired, and it's Monday, and you write, and you're inspired, and then Tuesday comes around, and you go, oh my God, you know, I've lost the thread. Sorry, I had this idea. Have you ever heard of, like, the Minotaur? Anyway, it's a bad tangent. Don't worry about it. You know, to get out of the labyrinth, he needed a thread, and I always think of, like, you know, you don't want to lose the thread because you're lost in the labyrinth with the Minotaur. I mean, to get the guy, whatever his name was, I forget. The hero. The Minotaur was the monster. But anyway, you want to remember the thread. You want to pick up that thread, right? You could, if you feel like you could go back and read, like, it through. If you could, but that's kind of dangerous because then you get to, like, you could maybe... Right. So maybe don't do that. Maybe as you're finishing that day, that writing period for the day, maybe get some post-its and write things like, remember, Jeff is really excited about klezmer music. You know what I mean? And he's going to have, you know, blueberry pancakes tomorrow morning and he can't wait, you know, like that. So you write little notes for yourself. As if the characters are writing your notes, or even pretend the characters can write you notes. Hey, remember when you pick me up tomorrow, remember that I'm doing such and such. Little post-its like that, which will give you a handle on it without having to reread, because we don't want to reread because you could like get into like self-loathing about it. This is like a version of On the Road.
I guess it's a
play. See, it's like a road trip. It's a show. Everything's a play. Everything. All the world's a stage.
Well, we need two chairs, basically, so come over here.
I don't want to come over here.
I don't need that table. She does, but I don't. So.
It is a play.
Yeah.
It is a play.
Yeah.
It is a play.
It is.
Yes. Hi, you're back.
Yeah, I'm back.
I'm not making a list. Yes.
Okay, so this is sort of has to do with inspiration.
Yeah.
So I entered a contest, which is like a blogging novel contest, and when I wrote the thing, I thought it was like the most brilliant thing, which was good.
Yeah.
Which kept me going. I had an idea, I thought it was great. Yes, and I entered the contest, and I was like, why haven't I gotten an award yet? But I won. Like,
right.
People haven't heard yet. And then of course they announced all the winners, and I didn't win. And so then I was like devastated. And then I thought it was terrible. So I guess I was just wondering, then when I went back to read the thing, I was like, oh, it's not very good. You know, so my opinion was completely changed by the response it got in the world, which was rejection. And so at least I think I'm really well in writing.
Right, right. That's
but it's the but that but I get discouraged easily and I don't send stuff out very often. And
right.
So I was wondering, I don't know if you could talk about like rejection or just the kind of disconnect between how we feel when we're making something and then how we feel if it's not received or
want it to
approve that.
And that, those are extreme, that's an extreme situation, you know what I mean? You've written something, you love it, it's probably very good, and then you send it off to a
right.
contest, and you're hoping to win, and you don't get what you hope for, and then you feel like poo-poo, right? So that's very extreme. Usually, most of us deal with, we do a show, and the critics do either this, or somewhere in between.
Yeah.
It's not like, we need a prize, or, you know what I mean? We need a prize, that's a very extreme.
Well, it wasn't even a prize,
Right.
So do you think that it seems extreme the way I'm describing it?
Oh, no. I'm just saying it's like a lot, you know,
yeah.
a lot of feeling wrapped up in that. So
right.
there's a lot of room for like elation or devastation.
Right.
That's tricky. So you're in a difficult place. I'm just acknowledging that it's hard, you know.
Yeah.
I think it's great that you wrote it. I think it's great that you sent it off. I think it's great that you entered the contest. And I think you felt naturally what anybody would feel, darn, I didn't get what I wanted. You know, I think all your feelings are right off the money. It's just, how do you keep going after you've experienced something like that? Okay? And I would say have backup. You know, have a backup plan. You know what I mean? Think of it like, I don't know, dating or life, you know? You know what I mean? You're like, you're hoping it doesn't work out, you have a bench, like in baseball. You know what I mean? They've got a whole bunch of people who play. And you have to just realize that you could, and Tennessee Williams said something to the effect of, you know, praise and good reviews and bad reviews are both devastating, equally devastating, because a good review will swell you and you might never work again. So there's that too. You know, getting praise is not everything we think it is, and you know that. I would just say, recognize that it might set you back either way, and keep going. Everyone asks me, you know, how do you keep going after you win a prize, you know? What do you do the next day? What do I do the next day? I keep going. I don't even think about it, you know? Or you get a good review in the newspaper, I don't even think about it. Or you get a shitty review in the newspaper, I don't even think about it. Because that's not why I'm in the business. You know what I mean? Getting published is important, you know, and you want your work to be recognized. I'm not minimizing that. But you also, more than getting published, you want to keep writing. So have your backup. You know, if you're sending your work out to magazines or producers in the theater or whatever, send out to more than one contest, more than one journal to publish, more than one publisher, more than one producer. Spread it around, you know, and it's good. Keep going, you know. It's like,
fucking motherfucker, you think you're gonna stop me? But you know what I mean. You know what I'm saying? I had to get off the mic. You know what I'm saying, right? Imagine there it is. Ha ha. You're not gonna make me right. You know, it's like, excuse me. Right?
And she pranked.
That's who are you again? Exactly. You know, like, you know, that person, that resistance needs to sit down. You know, you have your resistance, there it is. And whatever it looks like, whatever it's wearing, you need to sit down.
Right.
So you need to get black on it.
Get
black on it. Hello,
yeah.
Excuse me, you need to sit down. You know what I mean? You can go wherever you're from. You know, and even if you are from, you know, get black on it. You know what I'm saying? That's a way to keep on keeping on. And that's what you want to do. You want to keep on keeping on. You want to keep going. And you want to keep coming here.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's also weird because like, when I got upset, when I got the rejection, whatever, when I got upset, what it makes me realize is there's like a lot of demons in there that I don't normally acknowledge. You know what I mean? Like, if I get a rejection, it kind of like brings up these demons. They're probably there anyway, but I just normally ignore.
You know what I mean? I know what you mean. I know what you mean. The rejection, those, it brings up a lot of demons that you probably ignore. And you spend all your waking hours beating them back down, keeping them locked in the basement. And when one of those things, you know, ha, there it is, enormous. I know, and we all have them. And you just need to, you know, can you work your neck? Can you do that? There you go. That's it. See, you can do it. See? That's right. That's right. Just excuse me.
I don't think.
There you go. That's it. You just put that on. You know, and then they'll be like, oh, I thought you were Elizabeth. I'm sorry. I'm looking for Elizabeth. And they'll go somewhere else. And there you'll be. And you will have beaten them back one more day. And that's all you need. Just to keep them back one more hour. You know, they'll never go away. But if we can just buy another hour, another word, another paragraph, another story, another play, another line, another minute, you know, and confuse them just a little bit more. We're done. Thank you.
Anyone can come and ask your questions.